Hello and welcome to Faction Wars Game 1 between the Space Marines and Ordo Malleus. Starting off on the blue side, we have Ordo Malleus. First player for that team is going to be Ace of Swords, playing as the purple brother captain. Hiveminion, also in the center, playing as an orange brother captain. And 531st going to be playing as that red, kind of maroon brother captain. Since Ordo Malleus only have one commander, we're just going to see brother captains from them purely. Moving on now to the red side, the Space Marine side, we have the Apothecary played by Finale in the top side of the map. Broodwich in the center playing as a green force commander, and finally for the Space Marine team, we also have Floid playing as a Techmarine. I know that I said I didn't actually have any more replays, but I actually forgot about these few. Might have also zoom out the camera as well, but in this first engagement, going to happen in the top side, but Finale is going to get forced up as he's up against two people. Hiveminion is joining the fight in the top side of the map. Meanwhile, Broodwich is capping up the center of the map. The Apo is going to struggle here, still has his heal available, but might have to get used on these tactical marines fairly soon. Scout's so low that they should actually probably just leave the fight in this engagement. The heal going down onto the tactical marines. But Tac's going to get outmatched against the strike squad in melee combat due to the strike squad having that higher melee skill. We'll be able to land specials there, and the Apo is actually going to go down in that first engagement, getting special there by the strike squad. Rough Captain going to tie up some scouts. Meanwhile, Strike Squad is just going to demolish these tactical marines, landing the special, doing higher melee damage as well. And a very early shotgun blast is going to protect those tactical marines from losing a model, but the Apo has already gone down in this engagement, and that's quite a big loss there for the Space Marine team. The Apo is in a fairly easy position to get res, but losing the commander so early on is going to make the Space Marine army that much weaker early on. Space Marines will struggle against Ordo Malleus in the first few engagements, but Space Marines will be able to shine in Tier 2. But in Tier 3, it can be anyone's game when Paladins and Terminators start hitting the field, mainly for Ordo Malleus. You know, in the bottom side, Floid going to go for a sniper rifle here on his scout squad. Sniper rifle very effective against Ordo Malleus, given that they have a lot of heavy infantry, and given that the ISTs only have 100 HP, and the scouts do 90 damage per shot, it's very easy to try and bleed off some models on an IST squad that is not full health. If they are slightly damaged, you can easily bleed off models on the IST. You know, snipers are going to fire away there, doing quite a lot of damage there, bringing the IST down to just 390, but losing a sniper model there. Sniper scouts do cost power to reinforce, unlike regular scouts or shotgun scouts, so you need to be careful about bleeding models away from them. They're actually quite a lot of power, I believe they're about 6 power per model, so you only want to bleed a couple models. If you bleed a couple of models from them, you just want to reinforce them back up to 2 models, because you don't actually need any more than that. But Devastator's going to set up here, but there's 2 brother captains, and we are the hammer does actually stack together, so the damage resistance and movement speed from 2 brother captains with both the upgraded swords is going to be a bit too much for these Devastators to actually handle. Brother captains should be able to just charge up into them, and Hiveminion is just charging into the base right now just to interrupt these Devastators, and is actually going to be able to take down a model here by the looks of it, with that special knocking the Devastators away, preventing the brother captain from being able to finish off the model. Although IST pushing in, and a strike squad right outside the base here of the Space Marine players. Shotgun scouts going to go in, and ASM for the Brood, which are going to engage, but these ASM might find themselves outmatched, only doing melee damage, not the most effective against heavy infantry, but later on when they can upgrade with the sergeant who has a power sword, will be better equipped to deal with them. Not Force Commander also going to go in, a power sword here for Brood, which a very nice choice given the amount of heavy infantry on the field right now. ISTs arming themselves with Acolyte Leaders. The Acolyte Leaders do provide a damage boost to the squad by 25% and also provide health regeneration in an area by 0.25 health regen, and it does stack with other models. And on the bottom side, Brother Captain a little bit overextended there for Ace of Swords. Floid doing a nice job of trying to hold the area, isn't going to give up his power just yet, but things are looking a little bit grim here for the Space Marine players. Although Malleus's stronger Tier 1 is really paying off here, and Space Marines are down in terms of power. We know Ordo Malleus sit here with 2 full generator farms and also 2 power nodes here as well. Tactical Marines Devastator is going to be pushing in, Grenade Launcher IST for Ace of Swords. Grenade Launcher is going to be very useful for tying up and getting rid of those Devastators. Also very good against Sniper Scouts in particular, since Sniper Scouts do need to set up just like Devastators. The Grenade Barrage or the Grenade Launchers are able to actually hit Sniper Scouts once they are stationary, if you time your attack correctly. These Tactical Marines though, for a Floid, slightly overextended, backing away. Devastator is going to reset up once again, but Ace probably going to be waiting for his brother Captain before he starts an engagement on that bottom side of the map. And the Apo has been resurrected here by Broodwich. Well, it looks like the Apo was actually just repurchased, given that Broodwich does not have that much XP on his Force Commander. Here we're going to go down on some allied tactical marines. ASMs are ready to jump. There's a perfect opportunity to jump. All the units are so grouped up, but they're waiting for the Devastators to get into range, or for the Devastators to have the range to be able to deal with the Brother Captains. Vengeance Rounds is a really nice choice against the Brother Captains, although I don't feel it's actually going to be worth it in this game. I feel like it'd be best to keep standard Devastators, because we are going to see a Rhino later on. The ASM for Brood, which is going to engage even further now. Do need to be a little bit careful, they are a little bit outmatched. Brother Captains are going to start swinging away with their power melee damage that they actually do by default with their default weapons. In fact, they've already got the upgraded power sword, so they'll be doing power melee regardless. Can be quite effective against those ASM, even though it's not much power melee, it's enough for it to be useful. But the Brother Captain, though, for a Hive Minion overextended, 531st, might find himself overextended as well. Force Commander is in position to try and finish off that Brother Captain. He is down to just a 59 HP. And killing two Brother Captains in a row, and that means there's going to be no reses in the top side of the map unless Ace of Swords decides to walk all the way up here, and that's going to come in extremely handy for the Space Marine players. Those two losses are massive. We can see that Hive Minion is going to repurchase his Brother Captain so he can get res on 531st. Meanwhile, on the bottom side, Ace of Swords forcing Floid off. And no surprises here, but Ordo Malleus is going to be the first ones to Tier 2, given that they have had their Generator farms for much longer than Space Marine players, and given that Space Marines have been down on Generators for quite some time, it only makes sense that they would be the first ones to Tier 2. This could hurt quite a lot. They could get a load of Rhinos out onto the field. Rhinos are extremely effective, very good at countering Razorbacks if Space Marine players were to opt for them, given that Rhinos can be armed with a Last Cannon or can be armed with an Assault Cannon. Only costing 50 power as well, they are slightly cheaper than the Razorback alternative. The Generators are going to be destroyed in the top side by Ordo Malleus on their way back in. Hive Minion coming in with the Brother Captain, going to get a res onto 531st here. You know, both players are going to group up. Devastators are set up, but operatives are here with Grenade Launcher IST. These Devastators are going to get forced off. Barrage onto the Devastators, these Tactical Marines really need to retreat away. Space Marines do need to fall back here. Broodwich though, keeping his Tactical Marines in, these Devastators just need to retreat away. There's no point in trying to get inside the building because they just will die. There are grenade launchers on the field. They will not be able to survive inside a building against grenade launchers, and this Apo as well needs to retreat away. Meanwhile, for Ordo Malleus, the first purchases are going to be a Dreadnought and a set of Purifiers. I really feel like a Rhino would be really good here, but we're not going to see one from either player. Cracking rounds on these Tactical Marines. I would imagine we'll see a lot of Plasma Guns from the Space Marine players come Tier 2. Plasma Devastators as well, a very nice choice for the top side of the map here for a finale, given how grouped up the Hive Minion and 531st seem to be a lot of the time. Plasma Devastators with just a single shot, say, into the right area here, can be absolutely destructive and force off two squads with just a single shot. You know, Floid in the bottom side seems to be handling his own here, holding his own rather, against Ace of Swords, doing a nice job. But Ace is going to make his way towards the center of the map here with the Brother Captain. We do see the Power Swords across all Brother Captains in this game. It's just such a good tool, and trying to counter Devastators, giving you the extra movement speed. The improved We Are the Hammer is an incredibly strong tool, and especially when it does stack with other Brother Captains, can be quite annoying. The stacked damage resistance and the stacked speed is a bit much, but Purifiers going to go in for the Emperor, getting used onto these Purifiers, or rather not for the Emperor, but Mind Blades actually getting used on them, giving them increased melee skill and also increasing their melee damage. Meanwhile, Vengeance Rounds getting activated here, these Purifiers barely not losing the model here, actually going to get into range and type these Devastators. They do power melee with the Exarch, or the, not the Exarch, but the Justica, doing heavy melee, armed with a Thunder Hammer. Going to be able to take down the Apo. These Purifiers nearly level 2 already. These Tactical Marines here could get wiped on retreat, but the Purifiers actually ignore them, and now Shotgun Blast to their face prevents them from getting Tactical Marine there, which could have been good because they would have leveled up from killing that Tactical Marine squad. And on the bottom side, the Dreadnought is coming out onto the field here for Ace. Does have a default weapon other than an Assault Cannon. Not an Assault Cannon, but a Heavy Bolter. Sorry. And Ace has actually opted for his strike squads to be armed with silencers. Silencers deem Inferno damage very effective against heavy infantry, very effective against all kinds of infantry, in fact. Also deals a small amount of splash damage, I believe. and in the top side, Hiveminion and 531st just going to destroy the entire journeys of farm there. Also, Vindicare Assassin coming out for a Hiveminion, already been upgraded with the, what was it called, the stealth suit, giving him the ability to infiltrate when behind green cover. There's also another upgrade on the Vindicare Assassin, which I believe is called the Extended Operations upgrade, allowing the Vindicare Assassin to have quite a lot of health regen, about 2.5 health regen, allowing him to stay on the field for much longer. He does actually have a very small health pool of only 325, but that 2.5 health regen really does come in very handy. Meanwhile, Floid actually gained a Dreadnought of his own here. Last Cannon is set up here for Floid to actually stop that Greyknight Dreadnought. The Greyknight Dreadnought has by default more health than the Space Marine variant, even though it is a ranged Dreadnought. The Greyknight Dreadnought having 1300 HP. At the same time though, Floid losing his Last Cannon Devastators really needed that in order to help deal against that enemy Dreadnought, who's now going to arm himself with a fist. And that fist does give the Dreadnought an extra 150 HP, gives it the Maelstrom ability, and also gives it the Emperor's Fist ability, just like a Space Marine Dreadnought. Maelstrom ability does give it the ability to knock back all units in an area and also sap some life from them, I believe. But the Melter Dreadnought for Floid, the Melter Dreadnought is a good choice. Wow, picking off a Strike Squad model. Melter Dreadnought, wow, very nice choice here for Floid. Does need to be careful since his Dreadnought no longer has melee resistance, but is doing it some work here, picking off some Strike Squad models. Problem is though that Dreadnought is going to be a very big pain without the Last Cannon Devastators. This Dreadnought is going to be somewhat uncontested in the bottom side until Floid can actually replace them, but there goes the Maelstrom ability, knocking over a Tactical Marine model and also draining a little bit of life away from it. The Melter Dreadnought is actually doing quite a nice job here. The Melter Dreadnought, very short range as well. Needs to be very close. Does a lot of burst damage though. Very effective against all kinds of targets since it is Melter damage. Don't normally see it too often. But it's very effective at picking off enemy models, given its high burst damage against single targets. Plasma Devastators are set up. Going to fire away. Going to hit those Purifiers. Not actually doing much damage to them. Only catching the tail or the front end of it. Just barely though. But Dreadnought, going to manage to miss that Plasma Devastator fire. Second Devastators do have Vengeance rounds. They cannot equip themselves with a Last Cannon, which is why I was saying that it's not the best choice, given that the Vengeance rounds aren't going to be too effective against those Brother Captains. Given the amount of damage resistance that they have, it'd be better off keeping them standard for a time like this. Meanwhile, Purifier is going to go in. Mind Blade's activated. The Apo does have the Power Axe. The Justica is dead on that Purifier squad. You know, a nice Plasma Devastator shot catching out both of those Brother Captains. The Apo is trying to do some serious work here. Plasma Devastator is going to fire once again. Those Purifiers may even go down in this engagement. They are so low right now. They do actually have the Justica gain repurchase, so the ASM will need to focus them down now. But it might be a bit too late. The Justica is about to come in and the ASM are now slowed down. The Apo is forced off. The Shotgun Scouts are in the vicinity, but unable to really do too much on the Brother Captain here for 531st, just pushing in even further. Meanwhile, the Dreadnought here is in the back lines with the Inferno Cannon. You don't actually normally see the Inferno Cannon on the Dreadnought. The Inferno Cannon does do courage damage, so you can actually suppress units with it. Very effective against blobby type units such as Imperial Guards, Tyranids, Orcs, or even Eldar to an extent, but I'm not sure why the 531st has gone for it in a Space Marine match. I feel like the Claw would have been a better choice here, just like Ace has gone for. Meanwhile, the Vindicare Assassin kind of walking around at a bit of a weird angle there, marking the Dreadnought as a target. Vindicare Assassin, the ability to switch between rounds effective against infantry and rounds that are effective against vehicles. Vindicare Assassin really can deal a lot of damage, and he can also increase his damage further with Mind Blades, but his animations are going a little bit weird. He's kind of walking, facing the wrong way. A little bit of a weird glitch. Meanwhile, Plasma Guns here for Floid in the bottom side. Plasma Guns are such a good choice against Grey Knights. Very effective in both Tier 2 and Tier 3. When they get Terminators on the field, those Plasma Guns are really going to put a massive dent into the Terminators if left unchecked. You can already see that the first set is starting to get built now by Hiveminion. He's actually going to get some out fairly soon. And while that Dreadnought is actually going to go down to Plasma, not the Plasma Fire, but the Missile Launch Tactical Marines were able to actually finish off in the end. One more missile was all it needed. And these Sniper Scouts here for a Floid finding themselves a little bit outmatched. Two Vindicare Assassins in the center here trying to chase down this Dreadnought on 2 HP. Might even die to just piercing fire. or from these grenade barrages, but the Blessings of the Omnizai has been activated now to repair this dreadnought by Floid. Mindblaze getting used onto the IST in order to try and finish off this dreadnought. Dreadnought just needs to keep on moving all the way back to base, and it is going to live overall. It's a level 2 dreadnought as well. That's always nice to keep your level units alive. Meanwhile, the Brother Captain going to be fighting an ASM squad alone here for 500 faith first. Meanwhile, these missile launched tactical marines tearing up the top generator farm. 336 VPs to 280. Strike squad is on its way towards the top side for a Hiveminion. These snipers, or these shotgun scouts, sorry, are going to take, in fact, they're just going to straight up die in that engagement. We're a little bit forgotten about running into two squads like that. They are going to just fall down. Meanwhile, Hiveminion, the only player is actually tier 3 at this point. Everyone else seems to be going for a much heftier tier 2s. Purifiers are now out on the field for Ace. Purifiers, again, power melee and heavy melee, very effective against heavy infantry. And even effective against super heavy infantry later on, although you don't really want your Purifiers to be fighting Terminators, unless it's the ranged variant from Space Marines. IST squad is going to meet its end here, now down to just two IST squads in total throughout the game. But Hiveminion does have Terminators on the field, which are now making their way towards the top. They are going to get the Liber Demonica, which gives the Holocaust ability, allowing them to lift up enemy units in the area. Meanwhile, that Plasma, oh wow, Plasma Devastator shot down a staircase, allowing the Apo to potentially get a Strike Squad model here, but it looks like he will not be able to get one here. Level 3 Apo, going to be level 4 now after killing a generator in the center of the map. Meanwhile, Floid is coming back in. Those Exodus rounds are very effective against vehicles. Do need to be a bit careful, though. Meanwhile, Purifiers are going to engage. Purifiers could actually do a decent amount of damage to this Dreadnought, but they're actually going to ignore it for now. Purifiers do have a heavy melee Justica, which can do some decent damage, given that this Dreadnought has no melee resistance, but the Dreadnought will still be able to hold its own against it nonetheless. But the Techmarine with the Accident Mechanicum doing a lot of damage here, and he is not getting focused down whatsoever. The Tactical Marines are going to be the focus here. The Tactical Marines, though, for a Floid, are going to go down by the looks of it, but these Purifiers are taking an insane amount of damage, might even go down themselves. And they will definitely go down themselves. I don't think that it's going to be worth it here for Ace to try and take down a Plasma Tactical Marine squad for a Purifier squad, especially if he loses his Brother Captain as well, where with the Unending Purge upgrade on him, does have 5 health regen per second for being below half health, along with the Blessed Aegis providing an extra 3.5 health regen per second. That Brother Captain is going to be very difficult to kill with just range damage on retreat. Nonetheless, big loss though for Ace, losing that Purifier squad. At the same time, Floid losing Plasma Tactical Marines, I feel like the trade is better for Floid. Apo going to try and engage here, does have that power axe, is fully upgraded, does have the armor, the apothecary, and also the advanced medical equipment, having a lot of health regen, the ability to heal an entire army at the same time, very slowly. Meanwhile, Space Marine players now opting to go tier 3. Meanwhile, all the Ordo Malleus players are tier 3 or are teching to tier 3 as it stands. But Broodwich is also now teching up to tier 3 as well, so we're going to see a tier 3 battle. 210 VPs to 263. The game has got a long way to go. In tier 3, I expect to see from the Space Marine players a lot of Predators on the field right now. Predator spam should be the key here for Space Marines to try and win the engagement. Purifiers, Terminators, and Paladins are going to struggle against the sheer amounts of Predators on the field, so we might even see some Interceptors come in from the Grey Knights, because they might already be expecting a Predator spam, and in fact we actually do have some Interceptors on the way here for 531st. Interceptors do have the ability to throw down crack grenades to stun vehicles for a short period of time, and also the ability, or also armed with Psy Cannons as well, so that they can actually deal damage, explosive damage, to those vehicles. Meanwhile, the army of the Apothecary coming in here, going to try and heal up his entire army, but Plasma Devastator is going to fall down these Terminators for a Hiveminion upgraded with a silencer as well at the same time. Going to be dealing insane amounts of damage in both ranged and melee combat. Meanwhile, the Librarian getting pulled in there by Psychic Lash ability, but Hiveminion's Terminators not paying attention here. Had Hiveminion's Terminators been paying attention, that would have been a dead Librarian there for Broodwich. The Terminators with their Force Halberds doing a lot of damage. They also do splash damage as well to units in the area, dealing power melee damage. They are infantry or melee superiority units, being able to take on anything that Space Marine can throw at them, with the exception of Lightning Claw Terminators, which go equal against them, I believe. You know, our Techmarine there in the center of the map gained Force off Strike Squad and Vindicare Assassin for Ace in the area. Sniper Scouts are doing quite a lot of damage to the Vindicare Assassin, actually having a Sniper v Sniper Bastard, but the Vindicare is going to lose that engagement hard should he remain in it. Meanwhile, ASM jumping in that Brother Captain is so low down to just 35 HP, but Holocaust going to go down onto the ASM, lifting them up in the air. These ASM may even die here. They are going to get healed up by the APO, but these Terminators are just dealing so much damage here. Meanwhile, Grenade Barrage into the area, and Interceptors are coming in with their Psy Cannons. Can always switch to Power Swords as well, if needed. They also arming themselves with the Grenades ability, so they can actually arm themselves with the Crack Grenades. Meanwhile, an Orbital Bombardment is actually going to go down. It's actually going to catch out the Space Marine Army here. Space Marines are able to push it further forward. Angel's Death is also activated as well, providing damage immunity. And also knockback immunity as well. Meanwhile, that Force Commander though is demolishing this Interceptor squad. That's a big loss there for 531st. Really needing those Interceptors, given that there's also now a Predator out for a finale. Interceptors are the key really for dealing with vehicles this late in the game. You know, a Librarian just running around without 531st Brother Captain on the field anymore. The Librarian cannot be picked up and tossed into the army. Meanwhile, this Predator is actually arming himself with a Twin Link Last Cannon rather than going for the improved armor upgrade first. Normally, you do see the improved armor upgrade first before anything else. Meanwhile, Ace with his Strike Squad going in very aggressively here. Paladins are out on the field. This Melted Adrenal is going to struggle massively against it. Meanwhile, friendly fire there for a Floid. He needs to be careful. Meanwhile, a Shockwave here for all these Paladins demolishing the terrain in the area. The Strike Squad will be able to get away with just 44 HP, and Silencer is going to be tearing down the Generator Farm. Floid may even consider going for a Predator himself at this point. Does actually have a Land Raider on the way, but I feel like Predators would be the better choice overall. Meanwhile, Purifier is going to be pushing in further. Psychic Field doing power melee damage, not most effective against a Predator in particular, and it's quite a costly ability as well at the same time. Meanwhile, this Melted Dreadnought is actually going to be doing quite a lot of damage to the Paladins if the Paladins are not attacking the Melted Dreadnought. As long as it can remain at range, then it will be all fine. Meanwhile, another Interceptor squad out on the field, this time for a Hiveminion. Interceptor squad has even been upgraded with the Justicar and also the Grenades upgrade as well. So the Predator for a finale will need to be a little bit careful. Predator's going to go in. Paladin's going to engage here. Paladin's dealing 200 heavy melee DPS, can also have Mind Blades equipped on them to increase that damage further. That Predator though is just stuck on the staircase, isn't going to be able to get away. The Vindicare Assassin also coming in from the assistance as well. But Paladins are unable to retreat away, and do need to be careful. They're taking a lot of damage here. If the Paladins go down, that is not going to be a very effective trade. 44 HP will be able to teleport away, just barely escaping there for an Ace. There's going to be another vehicle there on the map. There's going to be the Land Raider Redeemer, and if that goes mid, the Space Marine players can just push as three together in the center. The Space Marine players are losing quite a bit here. Now there's two Interceptor squads on the field. That's going to be very difficult for any other Predator on the field to actually do too much. At the same time though, Paladin is going to be in base for a little while there for an Ace while they try and reinforce backups for units. Brother Captain here from 531st, armed with the Holy Armor of Titan, giving them invulnerability for several seconds when activated. Meanwhile, Interceptors here equipping themselves with their Power Swords at the moment. Interceptors can switch between the Psy Cannons and Power Swords. Power Swords are very effective if you want to try and encounter some infantry instead, but you want those Psy Cannons equipped if you're actually going to deal with a vehicle. Now the Land Raider Redeemer is now coming into the top side of the map. We could see a Crack Grenade get thrown down. It's going to slow down the Land Raider for a little bit. Meanwhile, Purifier is just in the center of this engagement. All the Space Marine units can retreat to the Land Raider, but you need to be careful here, as Ordo Malleus are just getting a complete surround against them. Purifiers for 531st, level 3. Do not want to be losing them in this engagement. Meanwhile, there are going to be some Assault Terminators coming in onto the back line, going to try and go after the Interceptors. The Land Raider Redeemer is just still sitting in the area and is managing to tank quite a lot here. The Assault Terminators jumping onto the Interceptors. These Interceptors aren't going to be able to do too much, really. Land Raider Redeemer is going to be incredibly tanky there. Meanwhile, Lightning Claw Terminators coming in for a Broodwitch. The Assault Terminators getting the Lightning Claw upgrade straight away. The Lightning Claw upgrade is so good against Ordo Malleus, doing power melee splash damage. do need to be careful about overextending them. No librarian on the field. Without a librarian, you will not be able to warp those terminators away should they overextend. This strike squad, though, in a potential spot of trouble. Going to get absolutely demolished here on retreats. Ooh, one model, though, still alive. The Force Commander is going to engage. Let's have that Sacred Sand doing a lot of damage. And Terminator's going to teleport even further, but going to be unable to actually finish off the squad. Meanwhile, Vindicare Assassin, level 2 here for Ace of Swords. Force Commander is going to go in, get some specials there. They're still not going to be able to chase, and Paladins are coming back onto the field though for Ace of Swords, and Space Marines are going to capture the center. Floid going for some Terminators here, but the Techmarine unable to get any melee Terminator variants. I feel like these Terminators are going to struggle here for a Floid, and that he would have been better off with just going for a Predator spam instead, even with the Interceptors on the map. Meanwhile, that Rhino though taking a lot of damage, even Plasma Guns dealing some decent damage to the Rhino. They deal 20% damage to them. The VPs are ticking down here for Space Marines, 158 for 51. As much as Space Marines are on two VPs, they are sitting on the lower side of VPs. We'll need to hold their territory here as Ordo Malleus makes a massive push towards the center of the map. Terminators, Interceptors, Paladins, Strike Squads coming in, Vindicare Assassins as well. This Melted Dreadnought, level 3, has done a lot of work for Floid throughout this game, but the Assault Cannon on the Terminator squad, I'm not too sure about that. It would be very effective at countering the Vindicare Assassins, but Paladin's going to be engaging. Vanguard Veterans are on the field, but Vanguard Veterans going to struggle to actually counter these Paladins. Meanwhile, double crack grenades onto that Melted Dreadnought, preventing it from doing too much. Predator is coming down the staircase now, but these Paladins leading the charge though are just dealing so much damage. They do actually have themselves armed with Psy Cannons, more effective against vehicles doing explosive damage, the same kind of damage as Auto Cannons do. Meanwhile, the Vanguard Veterans are demolishing the Interceptors in the back line here. Terminators getting tied up here by the Brother Capson. You need to be a little bit careful. Floyd's Dreadnought's actually going to escape. Meanwhile, the Paladins for Ace are taking so much damage at this point. They really do need to be careful. And the Land Raider Redeemer is actually coming down for a flank. The Vanguard Veterans are on top of that Land Raider to actually defend it, fighting against those Terminators. Meanwhile, the Plasma Devastator shots are going to just rain down as well. Meanwhile, these Terminators are taking so much damage. The Vanguard Veterans could easily chase in even further. We're going to be jumping in after these Purifiers instead. Meanwhile, all the units are getting a little bit too low, just going to enter inside that Land Raider Redeemer. The Ordo Malleus currently on a 2-to-1 cap, bleeding Space Marines onto VPs that they actually don't have at this point. Brother Capson is very low at this point, going to be able to barely escape here potentially. If the Vanguard Veterans though get a melee hit onto him, he will go down. On the top side though, Brother Capson is making his way on top of the VP. Inquisitor of Stormtroopers are in the air, and Rhino is also coming down the staircase. Predator needs to push in further forward. These Terminators need to go in for the cap against the natural VP here. They really do need to make a push now. Space Marines are losing the top VP. They really need to make the push now, otherwise they're going to get out of this game. They're on 32 VPs. They cannot afford to wait around any longer in this game. They do actually have two nukes ready to go right now to use in the next engagement. Ordo Malleus now securing the top VP. Some units are on the way towards the top side. Meanwhile, there's some units on the way towards the center of the map. Need to just carry on driving and get a unit on top of that VP immediately. You know, Predator going to be able to take down the Rhino here. That Rhino's actually dealing a lot of damage here. Also having some help from a Vindicare Assassin by the looks of it. Predator does need to be careful. Looks like the Rhino might even go down though to the Orbital Bombardment. Paladins are getting called in as well for a Hive Minion. This Predator is so low, that Rhino is taking a lot of damage. At the same time, there are some Sniper Scouts capping the center of VP while infiltrated. Vanguard Veteran is going to be jumping in, going to go after Ace of Swords. Terminators here, who are just down to 4,000, or not 4,000, now they're down to just 700 HP, which is really low amounts. Tactical Marines also capturing that top VP as well at the same time, 126 VPs to 10. Space Marines barely clinging on in this game here. You know, the Vanguard Veterans are really doing a lot of work here for a Broodwich throughout this game. Paladins going to engage. They do have Mind Blaze activated, so we can see specials from them against the Vanguard Veterans. The Vanguards are going to jump out of the way. These Lightning Claw Terminators could probably just jump back into the fight, especially if the Vanguard Veterans go in to actually assist them. Purifiers are still doing a lot of work here for 500 Fate Fest. These Paladins, unable to retreat, do need to be careful about overextending here. 93 VP. Space Marines are actually pushing towards that center VP as well at the same time. And Ordo Malleus are struggling to gain control of that top VP. They are actually going to lose several squads up here, losing the Purifiers, losing the Paladins, and going to lose that Rhino as well, down to just 22 HP. Meanwhile, another call-in has been activated in the area. It's going to be some more paladins this time for a 500 Fae first, jumping in very aggressively there. It's currently a triple cap, though. Four Space Marines, looks like they may even be able to hold at this game. 500 Fae first is pushing in towards the top side. Meanwhile, Ace and Hiveminion pushing in towards the center. 46 VPs to 10. Space Marines are barely hanging in by a thread, and Space Marines are able to hold this area by the looks of it. Meanwhile, in the natural VP, it's actually going to get nuked. The frag assault there from the Land Raider Redeemer is actually keeping the strike squad off the VP. Space Marines are actually going to keep this triple cap here. Looks like they may potentially win the game. 21 VPs now, and Brother Captains are pushing in further forward. They're unable to actually secure a cap in the game. Space Marines are going to be able to barely win this game, hanging on by a measly 10 VPs after having such a poor early game. Game pushed down constantly, they're actually able to come back in the late game, where a lot of people would consider Ordo Malleus to be the stronger unit or the stronger team in tier 3, but they were able to hold, able to push through, and were able to take the first game of this faction wars, and we'll be moving in it. Hello and welcome to Game 2 of Faction Wars between Space Marines and Ordo Malleus. Starting off, we have Ordo Malleus, played by Ace of Swords. We have the Brother Captain with the angry face on the cape. Looks like Ace is a bit annoyed about losing that previous game, now turned onto his angry face cape. We have Hiveminion also playing as a Brother Captain, still playing as that orange colour scheme. And we also have 500 Fae First, who I'm going to assume, yep, is playing as that kind of red-maroon colour Brother Captain. Moving on to the red team, we have Finale once again playing as the Apothecary, going to be playing in the top side of the map. We have Broodwich in the center, switching over from the Force Commander down to the Techmarine, and replacing Hiveminion, or not even Hiveminion, sorry, replacing Floid is going to be Batpimp, who is currently in base with his Force Commander. It's going to be game 2 of Faction Wars. Meanwhile, Double Scouts on the bomb side here for Batpimp, his Force Commander now coming out of base here, going to be playing as that Salamander color scheme. Not sure where Floid has gone from this game, but we'll see how Batpimp does in the bomb side up against 500 Fae first. Meanwhile, on the top side, Scouts able to get in there before Ace is actually able to get in, able to get a cap onto the VP very early on. Should give Space Marines a small VP advantage if they're able to hold the VP for just even a little bit. Meanwhile, Strike Squad going to occupy the bottom building, sorry, which is going to be quite annoying. These double scouts, though, if they were to go for a shotgun scouts with double sergeants, could prevent any building use whatsoever from Ordo Malleus throughout the game. I feel like double shotgun scouts would be a really nice choice here in bomb side, as much as snipers are also a really good shot. I think that shotgun scouts do scale a lot better compared to sniper scouts, and are very useful in combat as well. You know, our Ace of Swords here in the top side, going to be knocking down Ace Scout model, going to carry on chasing down those tactical marines in the bomb side, though the building is still occupied. Very annoying, there are going to be sniper scouts, which are also very effective at dealing with units inside of buildings as well. But grenades can't really punish players hard should they try to use a building, though, in the future. Meanwhile, Brother Captain for a Hiveminion going to go in very aggressively, running over some cover here. Techmarine and Force Commander both backing away out of the area. These tactical, wow, special damage. Dealing a lot of damage, in fact. Brother Captain, all the Brother Captains, in fact, with their default weapons, do power melee damage, meaning they're actually more effective against heavy infantry and also commander armor. It's only a small amount of power melee damage, is about 34, I believe, which does translate into about 40-ish DPS towards Space Marine units. I am probably a little bit wrong about that number. I believe it's about 34. It's not much compared to, say, Force Commander, who does 43 melee DPS, but does give Brother Captain a small boost against heavy infantry compared to infantry. Meanwhile, Acolyte's going to be purchased here, and double sniper scouts in the bomb side for a Batpimp. In the bomb side of the map, given that it's a very short distance from base to base, sniper scouts can be very effective for picking off models and bleeding your opponent, and sniper scouts can always retreat and get back onto the field in a short amount of time. Meanwhile, ASM, Broodwitch, and Batpimp are going to be doubling up here onto the bomb side. Purgation has been purchased as well, which means if Space Marine do opt for a power farm on the bomb side, it's not going to last very long if the Purgation get their hands on it. Ace of Swords also pushing in through the top side of the map as well, as I can see from the minimap, and the Hiveminion is making his way down towards the bomb side. These sniper scouts do need to be careful against this struggle to get a proper angle here. That force commander though is going to go down to the brother captain. Should be an easy res though for the Techmarine Broodwich in the area. You know, double sniper scout's going to start dealing some damage here. Purgation are now out on the field. Brother Caps is actually going to get melee down by tactical marines. That's not something you see every day. Tactical marines killing the brother caps in melee combat. These sniper scouts are trying to fire away. Meanwhile, the purgation are slowing these tactical marines advance by suppressing them and slowing them down as they try to get in. But the brother captain goes to res the brother captain there. That brother captain not been onto the ground for too long. Strike squad actually engaging ASM inside the base pretty much of the space marine players. We'll be very fortunate actually for them to get away with there with two models, given how close they were inside the base. ASM also purchased here for a finale, a really nice choice when combined with the APO. We'll imagine to see the Parax once again from him. You know, purgation just firing out of windows. These tactical marines trying to arm themselves with a flamer, but I feel like Finale should just go for some fully upgraded scouts here with some shotguns if he wants to try and counter Ace from using these buildings. Meanwhile, the APO, not enough energy, so I should use the heal. These ASM and tactical marines should just back away before they lose any models here. They shouldn't lose models in this engagement. They are outnumbering Ace of Swords, but because of Ace using the building here, they should just decide to back away instead. And this is why tactical marines with the flames is not a good idea against the purgation, given that the purgation can just suppress the tactical marines and prevent them from firing. They will lose a model here. These ASM's going to lose a model as well. APO heal does come in, but it's going to be too late for that ASM model, and that's two model losses that could have been avoided by Finale from just backing away earlier on. And Hiveminion also pushing the natural generator farm here of the space marine players, taking down one generator, taking down a second. Of caps in there on the retreat path, going to be unable to kill any models given that those ASMs were also healed up before they retreated away, before they lost that model. And Ace coming in with his double purgations as well, some scouts coming in as well for a finale. They do have a grenade upgrade, should have waited for those before engaging the purgation inside the building earlier. Would have been able to probably hold this generator farm as well had he have just fallen back much earlier. Meanwhile, on the bomb side, space marines aren't gaining control of the bomb side as actually a Ordo Malleus generated by the looks of things though, so space marines will need to work on trying to capture that or destroying it. Meanwhile, purgations are just going to push in even further now to the other generator farm here with three generators. The double purgations will shred it down so quickly. They really do need to get in and start defending it now. Space marines cannot afford to lose that second generator farm this early on in the game, especially while getting triple caps at the same time by Ordo Malleus. Things were pretty grim in the first game though, at the early game for Space Marine players, where they were losing their generator farms early on, and it meant Ordo Malleus got to tier 2 that much quicker than Space Marine players, and it really did affect them later on. But the purgations are tearing down this generator farm using the attack ground. I'm not really a fan of the attack ground, I prefer to just target the generators normally instead. But the purgations are dealing a lot of damage here, going to be able to get a full generator wipe at the same time. ASMs are coming in, but it's going to be, actually able to save a generator. I feel like Ace panicked a little bit there with that retreat, should have just spread out and had one squad to finish off the generator and to finish off the second power node that started to get built there. The Space Marines very fortunate that they're able to actually retain at least one generator. Even one generator is going to come in very handy here, given that they lost five of them total. Meanwhile, Ordo Malleus in fact already tier 2, there's a dreadnought on the way for a hive minion. Finale is going to be the last person to tier 2, playing as the Apo on the top side of the map. Ace of Swords though, with his brother captain trying to pick up as many models as he can, going to be left alone though. Finds himself a bit outmatched here. The ASM could probably jump once again to actually finish off the squad, but a grenade is actually going to go down, it's actually going to miss. That is some weird pathing on the brother captain there. That grenade should have, by all accounts, actually gone and hit in. You know, the Force Commander going to engage by himself, does have that Thunder Hammer, 460 HP, does back away as soon as he gets the first swing in, not wanting to risk staying in that engagement for too long, not wanting to risk losing that Force Commander. Meanwhile, scouts do have grenades available, should throw a grenade onto the entrance there of that purgation squad, but unable to actually react in time, or the grenade is potentially on cooldown, so not actually firing it anyway. Not these ASMs though for Broodwich doing a decent amount of work. Grenade does get thrown now, but it's a bit too late as the purgation are easily able to sidestep it and carry on fire. What just happened there? What just killed that? Oh, Plasma Devastator's over there. Just managed to get a perfect shot into the purgation. Wow. I just saw them. They were there 1 second and they weren't anymore. Meanwhile, Hive Minion going to opt for a Plasma Cannon Dreadnought. The Plasma Cannon Dreadnought is incredibly annoying given that it actually has no wind-up time to fire. Has a big cooldown though. but the fact that it has no wind-up time to fire, it can just fire straight away without any warning whatsoever, and can be quite annoying. Double Plasma Devastators here, one or both of them for a Bat Pimp even. Going to be able to get a nice little shot there, not as nice as that previous shot against that Purgation, but still. That's going to be very difficult to repeat once again. Meanwhile, Hiveminion's Plasma Dreadnought is going to be a massive pain to deal with. 1300 HP. Bringing Dreadnoughts do start off incredibly tanky. Meanwhile, the Justicar for the Purifier squad is going to go down here. And that second model that's getting a little bit caught out there could also potentially go down to just ranged fire damage. And will. You know, on the bottom side, Space Marines are gaining control of the power. This turret should even consider upgrading to a missile launcher turret at this point as well. Meanwhile, Purgation squad has been upgraded with Psy Cannons. Tactical Marines onto the bump side here will be able to avoid getting hit by that Plasma Cannon Dreadnought fire because of the low ground that they're seeing on, but at the same time, it's a bit weird that they can actually fire through the ground here and fire upwards at them. You know, on top side, ASM going to be engaged in a strike squad. The Brother Captain does have the warding staff, which allows him to protect in friendly units, giving them damage resistance of 30% and also preventing them from being knocked over for 10 seconds. Meanwhile, double purgations though for Ace has just torn down the second journey to farm for Space Marine players. At the same time, Space Marines are managing to keep up in VPs, 363 to 332. Space Marines are not too far behind in terms of VPs. Meanwhile, Stern Guards changing ammunition to the Kraken rounds. Kraken rounds more effective against heavy infantry. Meanwhile, the Psychic Field going to go down for the Purifiers here. Going to engage these ASMs. ASMs without their power melee are going to be very ineffective at fighting the Purifiers who have more health and do have power melee and even heavy melee as well. You know, these double Psy Cannons are just demolishing these Stern Guard veterans. They deal a small amount of AoE damage and are going to destroy the other Journeys of Farm as well. Meanwhile, Space Marines are going to try and hold with a bomb Journeys of Farm instead against 531st here. Bat Pimp is trying to hold the vicinity, but his turret is going to go down. And with this plasma cannon dreadnought as well, it's going to just carry on and slowly destroy the Journey to Farm. Meanwhile, Mark Tar getting used onto the Techmarine, this Purifier squad is going to take an extra 40% damage, which is the equivalent of having no melee resistance whatsoever against these ASMs. I do need to be very careful here. Merciless Strike going to go down, Plasma Devastator is backing away here. And that Mark Target is going to be very useful later on in the game against them. Meanwhile, the combinations here, the Grenade Barrage into the Plasma Cannon fire there. Just forcing those ASM off. Tactical Marines also backing away here. Two people is just too much there for a Bat Pimp in the bottom side of the map. Or even Broodwich, actually, because he's a Tech Marine. Bat Pimp is the Force Commander instead. Getting the players confused. I'm used to seeing Broodwich as a Force Commander like it was in the previous game. And now the bomb Journeys of Farm for the Space Marine players is getting bashed as well. Things are looking very grim for them in this game. Losing so much power throughout the game. These double purgations are incredibly annoying here for Ace of Swords. Nali is having a bit of a tough time actually dealing with them at this point. They offer so much damage up front until the ASM jump on them. The ASM can only tie up one squad at a time. They're also having to fight the strike squad at the same time as well. Kraken rounds are activated. Brother Captain is also coming in. That Nemesis warding staff, as much as it's protecting allied units, is also dealing quite a lot of power melee damage. Going to go and try and tie up that Stern Guard veteran squad. ASM are jumping onto the second purgation squad, though. Do you need to be a little bit careful about chasing in a little bit too far, because there are a set of purifiers on the way, which are level 2. You know, in the center here, Purifiers for 531st, going to engage some Tactical Marines, some friendly fire, well not friendly fire damage actually, that's a Hiveminion's Plasma Dreadnought there firing away. Meanwhile, Devastator's going to misfire there, but the Justicar once again dying for 531st. Does need to be careful, these Justicars do cost 25 power a pop. Meanwhile, it looks like Broodwich could try and jump in a little bit further to try and pick off some models, but it's going to be quite risky in doing so. Given that he's going further into enemy territory, able to take down two models there. That's very nice though for his ASM, who are now at level 3. Strike squad going to arm themselves though with a silencer. I nearly forgot the name of it. Purgation is firing away as well from distance, doing a small amount of splash damage to these ASMs who are all grouped up though. Although with True Sight now running out of cooldown, they do not have the extra range that is needed. But these ASMs are going to lose a model, but the sergeant is still alive. Meanwhile, on the top side of the map, Ace is just pushing in further and further, and that Journey to, or Power Node is going to go down. This Journey to Farm is also in risk of going down as well. The Apo, I'm not sure what he is doing there at the edge of a building, but he is potentially going to go down here to this Purifier squad. One more melee hit is all that's needed. In fact, they may even be able to finish off with just Storm Bolters alone. drop pod is going to come in. It's going to be the commander drop pod, so it's going to be a tactical marine squad inside. Going to reinforce those ASM and Sten guards back up to full models, and also providing a tactical marine squad only for just 350 requisition, 100 red. Techmarine though for Broodwich, arming himself with the Melter gun. Not too sure why he's gone for the Melter gun. I know that there is a plasma cannon dreadnought on the field, but I'm not really a fan of the Melter gun against or in this particular matchup. I feel like the plasma gun would have been the better choice to just stick to, given the sheer amounts of heavy infantry on the field. That plasma dreadnought is going to be very difficult to actually tie up with just a Melter gun, given that it's got such an incredible range on it. Meanwhile, Ace is going to get forced off here. Was able to take down two Jerrys, has nearly taken down the entire Jerrys of Hum. It's just down so low, 329 VPs to 308. Dreadnought going to be hitting some terrain there, unable to actually hit any units there. Meanwhile, Wellwind doing some nice damage here. Sniper Scouts firing it away inside that building, able to pick down some models, but Hiveminion is going to be pushing in even further. Another warding staff though for Hiveminion as well. Ace with a warding staff, 531st, the only person without a warding staff, should probably consider getting a warding staff. You know, our Predator is out on the field. I'm actually surprised that Bapim's got Predator out so early, but he went for actually quite a light tier 1, in fact, only going for a Plasma Devastator, so this Predator may even pay off. This Predator is actually really needed. It's going to be very effective at countering the Dreadnought on the field. Scout's going to throw a grenade. This squad is probably going to die, and will eventually die. Hiveminion overstaying his welcome inside that building. Wow, the Strike Squad game pops as well. He might lose both Strike Squads here, and that would be quite painful if he does, but that Strike Squad able to avoid the Plasma Devastator fire. Meanwhile, the Whirlwind is just so low right now. Purgations were able to get close enough to fire away, but we're not able to finish it off. Meanwhile, the Hunter Seeker missile, the Predator, and the Plasma Devastator shots onto this Dreadnought are all going to stack up big time here. The Predator needs just one more hit. But wow, the Plasma Devastator is going to be the ones to actually finish it off, but Ordo Malleus are pushing all the way into the base now of Space Marine players. They do need to be really careful. You know, our Purgation taking an insane amount of damage, down to just a single model. The Predator could just focus it down right now. It's down to 112 HP. Predator could focus it down, doesn't focus it down in time. You know, the Brother Captain inside the base of the Space Marine players, 320 VPs to 278. It's now going to be a triple cap for Brother Captain or for the Ordo Malleus players soon enough, with the IST on the top of that VP. Meanwhile, tactical marines coming in for a flank as well. These IST taking a lot of damage. Meanwhile, this Predator is nearly level 2. We need to get that leveled as quickly as possible so I can provide more damage to the Space Marine team and also have that extra tankiness, which is actually needed as well. Meanwhile, Finale is still struggling a little bit by the looks of it in the top side of the map, as Ace is going to be pushing in once again to the Jerrys of Farm. There's only one Jerrys there. Two Space Marine players are tier 3. Hiveminion's actually not tier 3 himself though, which is a bit of a surprise given that he hasn't had his power bash so many times. But 320 VPs to 223, things, I keep saying they look grim for Space Marines, and it has looked grim throughout the entire game almost, with the Jerrys of Hum losses really adding up now at this point. It looks like Hiveminion might even lose another Strike Squad. Vanguard veterans on the retreat path of his Strike Squad. Whirlwind firing away inside the building, Sniper Scouts also firing away as well, the APO coming in. Meanwhile, where are these shots like flying from? But the Plasma Devastator is there for a Bat-Pim just flying around here. I think he's ground targeting the building at this point, does unset up and will move away now. Meanwhile, Purifiers are coming in, these Vanguard Veterans, while they deal a lot of power melee themselves, we need to still be careful against these Purifiers who do actually have more health than them by quite a bit, who are level 3 in fact. You know, Plasma Devastator is there for a Bat-Pim backing away. The APO is coming in, does have himself armed with a Power Axe, but that Power Axe isn't going to do too much to an entire squad at this point. You know, Plasma Devastator is going to get a shot in, but they're actually going to die because not even going to get a shot in, they actually leave a little bit too early there. APO really needs to heal that Plasma Devastator. Wow, the special though from the APO is actually going to protect Bat-Pim's squad there. That APO really doing a lot of work, level 4. Purifiers though, not losing a single model. Meanwhile, Predator is still out on the field for a Bat-Pim. Is going to get some ASM, presumably going to upgrade him to Vanguard Veteran straight away there. You know, our Strike Squad not getting knocked over whatsoever there for some reason. Predator doing a lot of damage, but here comes the Land Raider Crusader though. Getting called in for Ace of Swords does cost a lot of resources. Oh wow, the Predator's also going to go down. That is really needed for Space Marines in order to try and counter that Land Raider Crusader. The Crusader does have 3,250 HP, making it one of the tankiest super units in the game, given that it does have a vehicle armor. what is actually the tankiest unit in the game, which does have vehicle armor. In fact, given that other super units like the Grey and Clean One and the Avatar, while they do have more health, are just super heavy infantry. You know, the Crusader is vehicle armor, meaning that only you do need last cannons, you do need missile launches, you need everything else to try and counter it. Warding staff getting used here onto the purifiers, giving them 30% damage resistance and also preventing them from gaining knocks back whatsoever. So that friendly fire there onto the Vanguard veterans is really hurting them big time. Brother Captain though, very low here for Ace of Swords, will be able to get killed here. Meanwhile, Ordo Malleus are just slowly pushing in further and further. Psychic Field going to go down here for the purifiers, but the purifiers do need to be careful. The interceptors also arming themselves with power swords, but the interceptors potentially going to go down here. We'll be able to barely get away there with 20 HP. Meanwhile, Orbital Bombardment going to catch out some Tactical Marines and Stand Guard veterans here of Finale. Meanwhile, Interceptors, I'm not even sure what they're focusing at this point. Looks like they're focusing the building for whatever reason. Meanwhile, there's a weird-looking Stand Guard model that's just flying around. What are these Interceptors actually focusing down? Looks like they're focusing down the bunker still. Oh, there's a Techmarine inside the bunker. That's probably what they're focusing down. Without the health bar, it's very difficult to see sometimes. The Crusader going to be pushing in further and further. There is going to be the Orb of the Omnizar going to get thrown onto that Crusader. It will be stunned in place now for 12 seconds. A Melter Bomb is also going to get thrown down. Vanguard, there's just a lot of power melee and a lot of units that are not really equipped to deal with the Crusader, to be honest. Crusader, though, is going to find himself a bit outmatched here. These Hurricane Bolters are doing an incredible amount of work, though, and just trying to suppress units in the vicinity. The Whirlwind has already used its Hunter Seeker missiles, going to be on cooldown for quite some time. Vanguard veterans do have a Power Fist. That Power Fist is not going to be too effective against the Crusader when it does have another 1000 HP to try and break through. Meanwhile, Crack Grenade going to get thrown onto the Vanguard veterans there. It does drain it of energy. Meanwhile, on the top side, Vanguard veterans are going to be jumping onto a strike squad. There is also a Rhino on the field, though, with an assault cannon, dealing an incredible amount of piercing damage when it is actually facing the units head on in. So the Storm Bolts can also fire. It deals about 80 piercing DPS, I believe. The Purifiers are just dealing so much more damage than the strike squad. This is because the Purifiers are leveled, and these Vanguard veterans are not. Purifiers have been in the game since tier 2. You know, the Vanguard veterans, a tier 3 unit, have not had the opportunity to level quite like the Purifiers have. You know, Scout Squad is getting a little bit low, is able to just sprint through the army here by themselves. Not going to die whatsoever. You know, Plasma Devastator is going to fire away here, going to hit those interceptors, and Orbital Bombardment is going to go down, going to catch out a double purgation set. That Orbital is dealing a decent amount of damage though to that Land Raider. Plasma Devastator, if they can carry on firing, Bapim is only down to just a single one though. Another Orbital Bombardment is going to go down, but no Melter Bombs to actually land onto that Land Raider Redeemer. Plasma Devastator hit is also going to hit as well, but it's not actually going to be able to do enough damage. Meanwhile, Purifiers are chasing further in. The Land Raider Crusader is going to live. And Vanguard veterans are going to be left alone now, fighting Purifiers once again. These Stand Guards really need to switch back to Kraken rounds. There's no need for these damage over time rounds to even be activated in this game. There's only two IST scores on the field. The majority of their fighting is against heavy infantry, and Kraken rounds deal bonus damage to Commander Armor as well for Stand Guard veterans. Tactical Marine Kraken rounds, however, still do not deal bonus damage to Commander Armor. Meanwhile, Drop Pod is going to come. It's going to be a Venerable Dreadnought here. Venerable Dreadnought could be a nice idea, but given that there's two Interceptor squads on the field, and given that it's just used its charge, it's going to find itself a little bit outmatched here. It's taking a lot of damage already. Look at the damage that these Psy Cannons are dealing to it. I do feel like a Venerable Dreadnought was a big mistake here, but it might be able to take down the Interceptor squad. That's actually going to come in really handy. With only one Interceptor squad now, it might be able to do a little bit of a better job. It's going to get halfway to level 2 already, but still though, Interceptors and the double purgations here for Ace of Swords is going to be too much, I feel, for the Venerable Dreadnought to even handle, even though it's got a lot of vehicle armor. At 1750 can be upgraded even further, but the Dark Age of Technology upgrade is still not going to be enough tankiness to actually last. You know, Stand Guard veterans backing away here from the Brother Captain, and Land Raider Crusader slowly getting repaired back up by the IST squad of Ace, which is also blocking the Rhino of Hiveminion at the same time. And Ace really not happy in the chat about the vehicle pathing of that Rhino. You know, our Hiveminion is still not tier 3 yet for whatever reason. 320 VPs, 220. Well, when it is going to be far away, but Paladin is going to come in to actually defend the natural VP. Interceptor is also going to teleport in with their power swords, but no Justica, so they do not knock back on teleport. But Vanguard Veteran is going to jump in, but going to regret this as they're up against Paladins and also Purifiers in the area. Shockwave going to go down. Venerable Dreadnought is going to push in, does have that Dark Age of Technology upgrade now, but even Paladins are able to stand up against a Venerable Dreadnought. But a Venerable Dreadnought is not going to be able to stand up against two sets of Paladins at all. You know, Holy Armor of Titan on 500 Fate Fest, able to just tank. That doesn't even matter though, because Ordo Malleus are going to dominate this game against Space Marine players in game 2, which means we will be going to a free game set. So I will see you. Hello and welcome to the third and final game of the faction war between Space Marines and Ordo Malleus. Starting off, we now have Space Marines on the blue side with Skizzy playing as the Techmarine to lead the team. We have Finale playing as the Apothecary in the center of the map. And finally for the Space Marine team, we have Hunter, who's already going in very aggressive there with his Force Commander. Moving on to the Ordo Malleus side, we have Hiveminion, who's once again playing as that orange Brother Captain, Ace of Swords with that unhappy face cape Brother Captain, and we also have 500 Fate Fest, who's playing as a maroon Brother Captain. Since Brother Captain is the only commander there for Ordo Malleus, we'll just see lots of Brother Captains. Meanwhile, the Strike Squad going to engage the Techmarine already. Brother Captain could just lead the charge though with the hammer of the Strike Squad. So you follow up and force melee onto these tactical marines here, which it looks like is exactly what's going to happen. Techmarine not focusing down Brother Captain as he tries to charge in, or not focusing the Strike Squad as they charge in, trying to focus down those IST, trying to bleed models away from them. Doesn't normally work out too well. These tactical marines though should consider forcing melee onto the IST with scouts, trying to focus them down to try and bleed some models and then back out the engagement before losing any models himself. Meanwhile, on the other side of the map, Hunter is pushing in very aggressively though with his tactical marines and his Force Commander. The Force Commander only doing melee damage, doing slightly less damage to heavy infantry. And the Brother Captain doing power melee, doing a small amount of bonus damage to heavy infantry, which equals to about the same amount of damage as each other. Just about the Brother Captain is much more tankier, cannot be suppressed, and also has a damage resistance with an increase in speed. These tactical marines were going in very aggressively to try and get a decap onto the VP, but Hiveminion coming in though with that special, able to knock them off the VP before they're able to actually get a decap on it whatsoever. And in the center of the map, Ace of Swords pushing in very aggressively though, nearly losing his Brother Captain, but scouts are going to go down though for a finale, and that's going to be a massive loss. Strike Squads do a lot of piercing damage at the very beginning of the game. They actually do more piercing damage than Tactical Marines. They also do more melee damage than Tactical Marines. Tactical Marines can make up for that by having the Kraken Rounds ability, so they can actually out-damage the Strike Squad when activated. But still, when it's not activated, their damage is lower. Meanwhile, these Tactical Marines really need to run away though for a Skizzy before they lose a model. It looks like they might lose a model. They're so low right now, but we'll be able to get away with all three models. Grenade is going to get thrown, but the grenade should have been waited for the Strike Squad to be forced into retreat, and then throw the grenade on retreat to try and wipe the squad since it was that low. And Ace of Swords going to be pushing in towards Hunter's side now. Hunter is actually going to get flanked from the side, going to allow Hiveminion Strike Squad to fire back with this Devastator Squad out of the picture. Meanwhile, a grenade barrage on top of the Strike Squad actually going to do some friendly damage there. The Hunter is going to lose a Devastator model here. It's going to lose a squad if the squad doesn't retreat away in that one model, or appearing to get stuck. We'll lose a model, we'll potentially lose a model on the Tactical Marines here. Strike Squad though for Ace isn't going to focus them down on retreat. Meanwhile, Finale though, his Devastators are set up, but the Brother Captain just circumvents that by walking around them. Brother Captain cannot be suppressed. He is too tanky to get suppressed. Now the Strike Squads are just going to try and force melee onto the Devastators, and they're now close enough that they can actually just charge in, and that the Devastators will not have enough time to set up. But things are going quite poorly for Space Marines at this point. Down 100 VPs already. The Apo is going to engage, but the Apo dealing minimal damage very early on without any weapon upgrade whatsoever is going to struggle big time. And also a Purgation Squad for Ace of Swords already onto the Generator Farm of Space Marines as well. You know, operatives are purchased here, but I'm surprised about the operative purchase for 500 Fate Fest, given that he's already seen that scouts do have a sergeant, given that there's already detection on the map. Ace has already managed to take down though two geniuses away from Space Marines. VPs now are going to be ticking down once again though for Space Marines, as they're now down to just no VPs whatsoever. It's actually a 1-0 VP capture, with the center one also getting captured up by Hiveminion, and with the natural one being left open for anyone's grab. With it being a 2-0 cap, Space Marine really do need to make a big push now together to try and get some VPs, because they're really bleeding quite a lot this early on in Tier 1, which is not a good start. Purgation Squad is going to try and go in for these Devastators here. We'll be able to get some suppression onto them, but these Purgations though are very low right now. We'll be forced to back away. You know, Strike Squad and second Purgation for Ace of Swords is in the area, but ASM are coming in for a finale with the APO support. It's going to be quite brutal to try and force them away. The APO healing them for about 110 per model for a total of 330 HP at level 1. Can be quite annoying. You know, Tactical Marines though taking a lot of damage here, able to actually get away with full models here. Very fortunate for Skizzy once again to get away with full models. You know, Hive Minion still going for that Double Strike Squad build, and now Ordo Malleus really taking up towards Tier 2. Meanwhile, Space Marine players are nowhere near towards Tier 2. Skizzy is the closest at 100 power, but the rest of them are not so close. Scouts barely escaping though for a Hunter, and the APO is going to push in even further. Tactical Marines are firing away. Devastators are set up once again, but Devastator is not really doing too much damage though to the Brother Captain unless he gets up really close. And even then, if he gets up too close, then he'll just start to melee charge in and will be able to run even quicker. Tactical Marines going to get healed though, are behind some green cover to fight the Strike Squad. And Devastator is going to be set up from the rear. The Strike Squad off Hiveminion is going to get flanked. The Brother Captain really needs to retreat away here. And the Strike Squad may lose a model. Will lose a model, in fact, from the ASM. That's actually very fortunate there for a finale. Meanwhile, Strike Squad going to be coming in for Ace of Swords with double purgations on the way as well. Do you need to be careful of that Jury's Farm? Double purgation will tear it down so quickly like it did in the previous game. Meanwhile, 531st is just locking Skizzy in base at this point. Skizzy now losing his Scout Sergeant, or his Scout Squad, which did have a Scout Sergeant on it rather. He's going to find himself a little bit outmatched now against this Operative Squad. Really needed detection from it to actually find these double operatives on the field, but these double operatives now can be anywhere, and Skizzy will not know. These Devastators are going to struggle without that detection, without that knowledge of where they are. They could appear at any time. 321 VPs to 494 Space Marines are making a little bit of a push here towards the right hand side. Could try and lock Hiveminion in towards his base here. Hunter though with his fully upgraded Force Commander. I'm not sure about full upgrades on the Force Commander in Tier 1. While it is incredibly strong, it doesn't actually appear as strong as it looks. Normally one upgrade or two upgrades is enough for just Tier 1 upgrades. You ideally want your Force Commander to have a Tier 2 upgrade at the very least, like a Thunder Hammer or a Sacred Standard later on. You know, Devastator's going to get forced up. There's a second set layering behind it, but this Brother Captain though is doing a nice job of just hanking it. You know, grenades is, or grenade barrage is on cooldown though for a Hiveminion. Mind Blaze is activated. Strike Squad model is going to go down. When Venture Trans are activated, the units do not get suppressed. But now that it's over, the Strike Squad is going to get suppressed. I'm not sure about Vengeance Rounds too much in this particular matchup, given that Brother Captains, or given that Ordo Malleus can always just come out with a very quick Rhino or a very quick Dreadnought. If they see you go for Vengeance Rounds, they know that you're not going to have a Last Cannon available in Tier 2 unless you repurchase another Devastator Squad, and they can just punish you by going for a Rhino or going for a Dreadnought. And it makes it very difficult to actually kill just Vengeance Round Devastators unless you go for a ASM with a Melter Bomb and hope that the Rhino gets too close or something. You know, Purgation going to be tearing down the Jurassic Farm here. Purgation's armed with side cannons doing explosive damage, very effective against all kinds of targets, including vehicles. Meanwhile, Razorback gained purchase, or Whirlwind rather, had the Razorback voice line. Whirlwind gained purchase. I'm not too sure about Whirlwind, given that you can't actually knock over the Brother Captain, and given that Brother Captains are just going to be arming themselves with warding staff so their purifiers can just not get knocked back from the Whirlwind and can just remain in melee combat uninterrupted. Meanwhile, Purifiers landing a special there. The Psychic Field also going to go down. The Psychic Field doing power melee, which increases over time. That APO though getting hit by some friendly Plasma Devastator fire. I'm surprised Ace just didn't finish off the APO there. Could have easily had the opportunity to do so, given that he's only on 220 HP and given how much damage Purifiers actually deal. You know, Hiveminion going to go for a plasma cannon dreadnought once again. Trite squad is going to have a grenade thrown at them, but not even moving whatsoever. We'll be able to just avoid getting hit by it. And Greyhound Dreadnought is going to be pushing in a little bit further. Meanwhile, Purifier is just sitting outside the base right now at Finale, and things are looking extremely grim here for Space Marines. I know I keep saying that things look grim for them, but in this game, things really are looking grim. They're actually all currently locked into base, unable to even escape their base at this point. ASM going to be pushing in further forward. Meanwhile, Venture Round Devastators and Plasma Devastators are going to help break out of the base here for a Finale. Meanwhile, a Greyhound Dreadnought is out on the field. A Techmarine levitating in the air over there, dead. Skizzy down to just Devastators and a Whirlwind. The Dreadnought is just going to be able to walk straight into base and do whatever it feels like. The Apo barely escaping there, and operatives are firing away. Will be forced off in the end. Another Whirlwind for Space Marine players. You know what? Devastators gain absolutely demolished here. May even die on retreats here. The Dreadnought does about 73 heavy melee damage. Should be able to finish it off though with the Hurricane Daughters. At this point though, could just walk in further into the base. I'm not even sure where the Whirlwind is though. Oh, Skizzy's Whirlwind is in the center there. That's not a second Whirlwind though for Finale. Meanwhile, Dreadnought though for a Hiveminion is going to be meleeing down that Force Commander, the Power Sword. Not very effective against Dreadnought. Power Sword, a really nice purchase in Tier 1, but with the way this game is going, that Power Sword is going to be a bit of a mistake. Given that they're so far behind with that upgrade, Force Commander should be able to push in a little bit further aggressively, but Skizzy's been locked into base for quite some time here by 531st. The Whirlwind is going to be a big target though now for that Dreadnought, which is now upgraded with the Plasma Cannon. Plasma Cannon, as mentioned before, does have no wind-up time to fire. Can be very annoying to actually play against, can be very effective against vehicles, but Space Marines are actually going to concede the game in the third and final game. Ordo Malleus are going to be the champions, going 2-1. I say champions, there's actually a lot more faction war games to get played before it's decided who's the champion, but in this particular case, Ordo Malleus is going to be winning against Space Marines. This third game getting absolutely destroyed. The first game was much closer, the second game was looking towards Ordo Malleus' favour, and to this third game was just dominated by Ordo Malleus. And Space Marines are going to lose 1-2, but putting up a really good fight nonetheless. And I did say that I didn't actually have any more of these replays, but turns out I did have this one, but now I really don't have any more replays, so I have to wait until some more games do get played, when some games do get hosted by Impregnable. So that's going to be it for Faction Wars for now, but as soon as I get some more replays I will be casting them again, because it seems to be quite popular and people seem to enjoy watching it. So thank you guys for watching, be sure to subscribe if you do enjoy this content. I'm off. We'll be right back.